Hello viewers, today we have with us Dr. Jayalakshmi TK, who is consultant pulmonologist at Apollo Hospitals, Navi Mumbai. Welcome, Doctor. Doctor, today we want to discuss with you about the topic COVID-19 second wave.
Hello Tejal, hello viewers. So as we are all aware, there is a new wave of COVID which is spreading all over Mumbai, Maharashtra and all over India. And which we had not really expected or anticipated, because the numbers had been steadily going down over November, December, January. Even the expected increase after Diwali, after New Year, it did not come. So sort of we were sitting pretty and relaxed that, you know, COVID seems to have gone away, now the vaccines are here. In fact, even I could see a lot of reluctance in the population to take the vaccine, also thinking that if COVID is not there, why should we really bother to take the vaccination? But COVID has proved us all wrong again, and we see a very alarming increase in the numbers. Like for example, yesterday there were about 60,000 cases in Maharashtra alone, and there were about 5,000 plus cases in Mumbai, and around 90,000 cases in India, which is almost nearing the peak which we saw in September. And what is new about this is what we are seeing is that it is spreading faster. Like the increase in the cases has been at least 2.5 times faster. The curve, the upward curve in the number of cases has been at least 2.5 times faster than what it was in the month of September. To reach that peak in September, it took almost 1.5 months. But in 15 days from March 1st to March 26th almost, we are seeing a sudden increase in the number of cases. That is one thing what we are seeing. Another thing what we are seeing as practicing clinicians is that earlier in the previous wave, if COVID affected one member of the family, and suppose there were about 6 or 7 members in the family, 3 or 4 would be infected and 2 or 3 would be negative. But now we are seeing that if one member of the family is infected, everybody in the family is invariably infected, nobody is negative. So this means that this strain has a much more higher capacity for spreading. And are we seeing an increase in the severity of the illness, that is more severe lung disease or any different pattern of the illness? No, we are seeing a very similar pattern of the COVID illness as we were seeing earlier. There is a similar percentage of the patients with lung involvement and similar percentage of asymptomatic patients. So that part is quite similar what we are seeing. And basically what are the factors that have contributed to the second wave? So I feel there are two distinct aspects. One is the nature of the host, that is how we have our behavior, and one is the nature of the virus. So we will speak about our behavior. So generally we know that after December there has been an increase in the unlocking measures, which was also necessary for the economy, for the people to work. So the trains have been opened up, the curfew has been lifted, so the hotels, the meetings have all again restarted to a great extent, and most of the offices have stopped their work from home approach and have started a physical working approach again, and people have started gathering more for parties or functions, marriages, funerals, whatever. So there have been events which have again started off where more number of people are gathering together. Generally, when people gather together for food or for meetings or for tea or snacks, it's not possible to wear the mask, or mask wearing is very less in such type of social events. So that is happening. The general alertness of the people in wearing masks, whether it be in a public transport or in a market, or it's reduced. As we can see, people wear the mask in the wrong way, the nose is not covered, or it's just hanging loose. So this type of we can say carelessness has set in the people. Also type of fatigue has set in, corona fatigue, whatever it is, let it be, I will continue to do what I want, is not possible to continue doing all the safety measures all the time, enough is enough. That type of tiredness or mental fatigue has set in among the people. So that is one thing. Then secondly, when you talk about the virus has also started mutating, it has started becoming smarter. So we have found internationally there are 3 main type of virus variants which are seen. One is the UK variant, that is a B.1.1.7 variant. One is the South African variant, and one is the Brazil variant, also called as a P1 variant. So in these variants, what is found in the UK variant is documented to spread 1.5 times more faster than the other earlier variant of the virus. So this UK variant is much more faster spreading. It has been shown to be spreading faster. And these variants are not only that is in UK or in Africa. They have been found even de novo, arising in various parts of the world. It's not that if we have that type of variant in India, it's only been brought from UK, and if we stop the flights from UK, that variant will not come. It's not like that. So there was a recent paper I was reading in Nature. So it showed that de novo, the same type of mutations, that is, most of the mutations come in near the spike protein, which is a part of the virus which attaches to the human cells. So in this part of the virus, most of the mutations are coming. And these are similar variants which are seen across the world, similar area of the virus, these mutations are seen around the world. In Maharashtra recently, a new type of variant, which is multiple mutations seen in the same coronavirus, that is not only in the spike, but also in the other parts of the virus protein have been found. So this is called as the multiple mutant variants are also seen. So so what happens with these variants is two things. One, that they spread faster. Two, some of the variants can even infect the people who already have some amount of immunity. So the previous little bit of immunity does not confer a resistance to getting the infection again. So these are the twofold ways that the virus is found to change and adapt and to continue its presence in the human host. And another thing, there is a misconception among people that although it's a faster spreading variant, it's a milder variant or it's a normal variant, so we don't have to be really scared about it. But this is not true, because a virus which spreads more infects more number of people. We know that the fatality rate is about less than 1%, 0.1 to 0.2% is the fatality rate, say 2 in 1000. So the more thousands of people who are infected with the virus, obviously the number of deaths are going to increase. And as corona infects more, it increases geometrically. There's a geometrical proportion, it keeps increasing. So as the number of infected population increases to a greater extent, the number of deaths also multiply to much more extent than if the variant was just normally spreading but little more lethal. So a faster spreading variant is actually much more dangerous, and it can cause a much higher fatality rate than a normally spreading variant. So these are the aspects of the virus. One is about the virus mutating, and these mutant variants have already been found in our population also. And about the host, about our being more careless. So these are the two things.
Thank you, Doctor, for giving your views on COVID-19 second wave. Doctor, we have few questions with us which we need answers on, which are like really going into people's mind right now. So I want you to answer them. The first question is, why there is a sudden drastic rise in the cases?
So as I've discussed earlier, there are two aspects to the sudden rise in variant. One is part from our behavior. There has been an increase in the people meeting. The social distancing, that is the use of sanitizer, use of mask, use of, you know, like they say, 6 feet distance, that is not being followed over the last 2 months. As we all know, everybody sort of let their guard down, seeing that the COVID virus cases have come down. Also, the public transport is opened up, meetings have opened up, parties have started, people have started gathering together for weddings. And all this has contributed definitely to the increase in spread of the virus. But second aspect also cannot be discounted, that is the virus also has mutated. So now what we are dealing with may be a different little variant of the virus with certain changes which is making it to spread faster and also counter the partial immunity which is there in the population.
Doctor, the second question is, what is difference between the first wave and what is going right now, the second wave?
So definitely we are seeing that the spread of cases is much faster in the second wave. So what this means is that the traditional social distancing measures which we have been following, like 6 feet distance or wearing mask or sanitizing, may not be enough to prevent the spread of infection in the second wave with the faster spreading variant of the virus. We may have to tighten up, because it's been found in some countries, in spite of lockdown, there has been an increase. Like in UK it was found that even in the month of lockdown there was a quite a rapid spread of the virus. So the traditional lockdown method may not even suffice in this new second wave because of the little difference in the transmissibility of the virus.
Doctor, are there any long-term consequences associated with COVID-19?
So over the last, we have been seeing from last March that there have been patients who are infected. The main long-term which we are seeing is the COVID lung involvement. So when there is a severe lung involvement and the patient has been in the ICU for longer time, requiring oxygen, and the CT scan is showing significant lung thickening or fibrosis, we call it, after the COVID event, or a lot of lung pneumonia has been there in the lung, lot of pneumonia has been there during the first admission itself. In such patients, there is a persistence of breathlessness, lung function abnormalities, which can last for 6 months, 9 months, up to 1 year. Many patients are requiring oxygen on discharge and they may have to continue for a few months after discharge. But hearteningly, we find that most patients, even with severe lung involvement, improve very well. And within 3 months, most of the patients go off the oxygen, and within 6 months, they are like almost practically back to their normal condition, what they were before they got infected. So the recovery is there. It's not a progressively worsening lung involvement as such, but the recovery is there. Another thing what we see is a weakness. We see some patients getting diabetes or blood pressure, which can persist after the viral illness. These are the other long-term complications which we are seeing.
Doctor, can we directly relate this to the unlocking which was done?
Probably, as I mentioned, definitely as more people gather together, because this virus spreads from person to person. It spreads with a geometric proportion. That is, one person can infect many. That if one person infects five persons will infect 25. So it keeps on increasing like that. So definitely, the unlocking will have an impact on the spread of the virus.
Doctor, does tracking really help in identifying the possible cases of COVID-19?
Yes, definitely. Case tracking, case finding, surveillance definitely do help. And India has also done a great job in this regard for case finding. Even now, when if there is a person who has traveled in a flight and one of the persons in the flight is found to be positive, immediately all the people in the flight and their contacts are contacted and informed as to the positive case. And this kind of case finding and surveillance has been continued right through from last year, from March onwards. And of course, it needs to be continued with a greater intensity and greater rigor, especially in view of the second wave. And it would help, because if a person knows he is positive, at least he is likely to stay in quarantine and not infect others. But if he does not know and he roams about to 10 different places now that there is unlocking and there is no curb on personal movement, the disease can really rapidly spread. Surveillance, case finding, case tracking, all are important.
Doctor, will the current vaccination program help in controlling the COVID-19 second wave?
So the current vaccination program will help, but considering the population of our country, as of now 5 crore people have been vaccinated. But in our country with such a large number of, this is just like a drop as yet. So this number of the uptake of vaccine in the population has to increase much faster. As and when now from 1st of April, it's opening up to everybody above 45, the comorbidity certificate is no more required. So people should take advantage of it and quickly get themselves vaccinated. Even one vaccine, one dose of the vaccine gives about 60% protection against the virus. And 100% protection is there after the both the doses for severe forms of illness, as well as of severe lung involvement, mortality. Death rate will be much reduced. You may get the virus, you may get the illness, but it will be mild. So that is a great assurance, and definitely vaccination will help in preventing the spread of COVID. But how much it will affect in this particular wave over the next 1 month, that we don't know. But over a period of few months, it will definitely help.
Thank you, doctor, for answering all our queries. Doctor, would like to know your parting comments on this topic.
So, actually, I would like to refer to a comment made by our Prime Minister, Mr. Modi ji. Savdhani hati, durghatna ghati. So, this is probably what we are seeing now. We all need to be more cautious, more alert. Each one of us is responsible has to behave as a responsible citizen, each one of us has to make sure that we don't infect others. One, we don't get infected, and two, we don't infect others. This is our responsibility, and we can do this by maintaining social distancing, hand washing, wearing masks, not going out unnecessarily, trying to do as many things virtually as possible, and taking the vaccine, and helping others and informing others of about all these things. Thank you so much.